Alright, so let's check out our comments. This should be in the internet. And it's like by Sparkman. There is the Sparkman channel. Check out the comments. And here are the comments. Okay, someone says, how do you do full screen in Gdevelop? Alright, let's do that. And here's the project we have been working on. We have scrolling and everything. Let me bring that in the window. Here is the worm. There is. Now if you don't have this file, check out the previous videos. Okay. I made a playlist so you can follow along and get up to this point. So let's do full screen. Okay. Now first I thought you could do full screen by selecting the properties here, but you can't. I also checked the extensions and you can't do full screen from here. Okay, you actually have to do it from events. So you should have something similar to this. If you don't, check out the previous videos. Okay, I made a playlist. Oops, did I already say that? I think I did. I'm forgetting everything today. I don't know why. So let's create a new event. Add a new condition. And this is going to be related to, let's see, the start of the frame, or start of the scene, at the beginning of the scene. At the beginning of the scene, we are going to add a new condition. And let's see, where was that? That's on their game window, okay, and it's right there. Deactivate or activate full screen. Super easy. So all you have to do is check this here. This is a yes or no, sort of like a Boolean expression, on and off. So now it's set to yes. So this game is going to start on full screen. I'm going to create another action. So let me just copy this, paste it. Let me change the condition to the user press a key. The user presses, let's say the escape key on the keyboard. And if that happens, we are going to set this to no. No more full screen. Okay, so let's test this out. Preview this on their windows, and you can see that nothing happens. Wow, what's going on? Is this even working? Actually, this is a preview. Okay, so we actually have to compile the game for this to work. So let's start the preview, and let's compile this game as a Windows game. Compile to a native executable. So the name of the project is Ninja Worm. Let's compile this. Okay, so here is our game. So let's open it. And there is our game on full screen. Wow, the frame rate is super smooth. It's almost like a real game. It's not choppy or anything. Even though this project is 640 by 480, that is the worm. So I'm going to press escape now. This is going to exit our full screen. And there it is. Wow. Just like that. So now you can make your own Undertale game for free using Gdevelop. Alright, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye now.